Libations, which is our show about mixology, as you all know. And we've been having an autumn adventure of drinking cocktails that are suitable for this time of the year, that are maybe a little bit heavier than what we would imbibe during the summer. And we're trying to basically focus on utilizing scotch in cocktails, because people tend to shy away from scotch, as I mentioned before, because they think it's too heavy for drinking purposes. And I'm going to remove my COVID mask, but I like to wear it in the beginning because I want it to be a reminder to follow the protocols for the safety of others and for ourselves. And I'm going to remove it now. But anyway, we find that we can go way beyond the stereotypical drinks that are made with scotch and really break out into using all kinds of ingredients that you normally would not use when you make a cocktail based on scotch. And most people think a scotch-based cocktail, and of course I've made the doctor's orders before where I use scotch and I believe it was elderflower liqueur. And that's a worthy cocktail, a very nice cocktail. And now we have some more on our repertoire to try out with ingredients that actually blend beautifully with scotch. And I mentioned this before in one of my other shows, don't ever think that mixology is beyond your abilities. It absolutely is not. It's like learning how to be a really creative cook, a good chef. It takes practice and time and getting a feel for what you're doing. And if you have a desire to do mixology, by all means experiment and try it. And don't think that this is the domain of those elitist type people who would like you to think those are the only ones who can do it, because that is absolutely untrue. So we're going to proceed on ahead with another cocktail based on scotch. And this particular one is going to involve muddling also, but it's going to be muddling mint. And again, you're probably going to think mint and scotch. Yeah, in fact, absolutely. Yeah, this is an interesting cocktail because it combines things that you normally wouldn't think of as being in a scotch-based drink, but it works beautifully. And we're going to go ahead and add the scotch to the mint right now. And then we're going to add some sugar to this cocktail. And by the way, this cocktail is called the Medlothian. And the Lothians are a section of Scotland that run between Glasgow and Edinburgh, the two major cities that kind of have a rivalry between them. There's West Lothian, Midlothian, and East Lothian, where Edinburgh is. And again, this is Medlothian, which is named after the Lothar Hills, which run through that section of Scotland. So how appropriate. And anyway, at this point, I'm going to add some sugar to this drink. And not too much, but some, because we want to give it a hint of sweetness, but not overwhelming. Plus, we're going to use another ingredient that does have some sugar in it. So we're going to add just a little bit of sugar here, because we don't want it to drown out what is supposed to be in there. And now we're going to add Jägermeister of all things, and you're going, Jägermeister in scotch? It works, because Jägermeister has herbaceous notes to it and minty notes to it. So it goes with the mint and with the herbaceous smoky qualities of scotch. And we're going to add a bit because we don't want it to overpower and take over the scotch. So the main ingredient in this drink, the Medlothian, is the scotch. And then we have the Jägermeister, the sugar, the mint. And then after I do the muddling, we're going to add some lemon. So I'm going to go ahead and muddle. And as I mentioned before, this is a cocktail for tasting purposes, not to serve a complete amount of the cocktail as you would at, you know, a party or function, or even if you're making it for yourself at home. So that way the mint has been bruised and muddled enough that we can get the oil infusion out of it and the flavor out of it, and I can smell it wafting up out of the cocktail shaker. So now I'm going to add the lemon. And this is a necessary ingredient for this drink. And you may be thinking to yourself, boy, that's a conglomeration of disparate ingredients. Is this going to work? Trust me, it works. So I'm going to go ahead and add the lemon, squeezing it in by hand so we can get the infusion from the peel, and then dropping the spent shell in the drink, because that'll further enhance the flavor in the drink of the lemon peel. And now at this point, I'm going to go ahead and add some ice so we can shake this up. And some people like to drink this particular drink rocks, but I think it's more appropriate drink as an actual cocktail this time of the year, because rocks is like for summertime, in my opinion, but you could do it that way if you want to. So I'm going to go ahead and shake it. And again, we're just going to get a sampling amount, not a whole amount of cocktail. And unlike with the other drinks where you don't really have to use, you know, you might say something to decorate the drink, we are going to use a little wedge of lemon with this one. So I'm going to dispense it as a sample into the glass. And this is a glass that normally would be used for drinking Scotch whiskey neat, but I think it works beautifully for cocktails based on Scotch. So we're going to add a bit of lemon to the drink now. Drop it in, and I'm going to go ahead and taste it and see if it turned out as it should have. The Medlothian. Oh, very good. Very good. Yeah, and the ratio of the Scotch to the Jagermeister is about right. Again, it should be approximately 2-1, or maybe a little less of the Jagermeister. And you're getting the herbaceous quality of the Jagermeister, which goes with the Scotch, and the minty quality of the Jagermeister, which goes with the muddled mint, which of course in this case is the conventional one that you would get. So make sure that you use fresh mint, like the fresh ginger and the fresh rosemary that I used in the other cocktails. And, you know, muddle them, or in the case of the ginger, you pulverize it basically after grating it on the grater. And these little steps mean a lot. It's better than using, you know, like fake mint, so to speak, dried. It's really better to use the fresh, and the same thing with the rosemary and the ginger. It just makes your drink more complex and more approachable than if you use a cheat method, you might say. And this really is very good. And again, who would think that you could use Jagermeister and things like maple syrup and rosemary with Scotch, but you can. And these are creative, interesting cocktails that are beyond the scope of what people think when they think of Scotch. And again, there's a myriad of Scotch-based cocktails. These are by no means the only ones that you could make. And these are kind of creations of my own, but you can find dozens, if not hundreds, of Scotch-based cocktails in books or even on the internet, I would imagine. And use your imagination too. Add your own flourishes and touches to it. You don't have to do things by rote any more than you cook by rote. So enjoy your Scotch. Enjoy autumn, now that it is actually acting like autumn and the temperature is getting cooler. And I want to thank you again for tuning in to another episode of Good Libations. I'm Ethel Andrews, a mixologist, and I want to emphasize again, like I always do, that we want to be very careful with our community to keep it safe and well spoken of. And even though we're sheltering in place, if we've imbibed, we want to be very careful about driving afterwards and very discreet and prudent in what we do. Thank you again, and enjoy sensibly and in moderation. Goodbye.